Yes, thank you very much. Thank you, guys. Thank you. I'm so grateful. I'm so happy. And of course, I always say it's by the grace of God that we saw today. Actually, if God, and I always say this in my Facebook, if God was to go to the book of the good people, if God was to go there and check the good people that are supposed to see the day, me and you could not be there. Are we together?
Amen.
At least one should be off so that I can hear. You know, sometimes you can freeze and you are just talking alone. Somebody should be there. At least you can allow me, you can alert me that I'm still going on. I always say God was to check the good people that are supposed to see the day, then me and you could not be there because there is nothing, brother and sister, we have done. Nothing. We have done nothing to God. But because of his grace, the sufficient grace, that's why we wake up in the morning without even considering who was there in the morning to take the charcoal or the firewood to make that sun right. Nobody knows about that. But when you wake up in the morning, the sun is there and you're there to go and bask on the sun, but you don't know, you're not concerned who did all this. It is our God. So if God was to consider the good people, that the good people are supposed to see the day, then we could not see because we have done nothing, nothing. Otherwise, I'm so grateful because of that grace of God. That grace is so sufficient, guys. And that's why today we are testifying. My brother Luke has testified what God has done. It's not because of the might of him. It's not because he has done, but because of God's might and, you know, mercy and all that kind. You know, that's why he's okay now today. And he is giving the testimony. There's somebody who was sick like you and he cannot give testimony today. There was somebody maybe went to the same hospital you went, but today he's not there. Maybe somebody went and used the same taxi you used, and at the end of the day, he was not there or she was not there. But you are here testifying that the God, Lord is good. So that's all the doings of the Lord. Guys, I want us to ask, my word today is, what are you doing? What are you carrying? The donkey, you know, okay, after I preach, maybe you're going to give your heading yourself. Maybe you're going to give your preachings, the heading, what you want it to be. But me, I want to start by saying, I want to speak about Abraham. And I want to say this, when Abraham was told by God to give sacrifice, amen. Are you still hearing? Ben, are you there now?
Yeah, we are hearing.
Yes, thank you, Julius, thank you. Okay, when Abraham was told by God to give the sacrifice, he prepared, just go together with me, he prepared himself. He took what was necessary and what was required. And imagine he was to give the sacrifice to God and he never told the wife. He never told the wife what he's going to do. Actually, he never disclosed the message to the wife. But he prepared, he took what was necessary, he prepared all the process, and he set off from home going to Moriah. And on the way, he had everything. He had carried everything, the process, everything. He knew what he was supposed to go and do in the mountain. He carried the two servants. He carried the ass or the donkey. Isaac was there. Firewood was there. And of course, the knife was there. But there was no sheep or lamb or goat. There was nothing. So when they went, they reached a point. And that's when I want now... my brother Luke, maybe to share that verse, because that is my message today, within a minute, and then you remove it. Yes. And Abraham said unto his young men, abide you here with us, and I and the land will go yonder and worship and come again to you. That's okay. That's okay. Now you can remove it. Yes, thank you very much. They reached a point. That is my message today. They reached a point, and Abraham told these two guys and the donkey, you are going to remain here, me and the son. We are going to go to the mountain to give the sacrifice. And when we are done, we are going to come back to you, and then we are going to go back. That is what I don't know whether in your life, I don't know whether you have ever asked yourself why Abraham left the donkey and the two servants there. I don't know whether you have been asking this question. Why did God, why did Abraham left these things there? And they came all the way from home. And now here, he left the ass, the donkey, and the two servants. Stay here. I'm going to the mountain to give the sacrifice. And when I'm done, I will come. And that is the place Isaac was asking the father. I can see the knife. I can see everything. But I cannot see the goat to slaughter. That is the point. But Abraham told the son, God will provide. God will provide. Even today, do not question so many things to God. Do not question many things. God will provide when you reach. The only problem is most of us, we don't reach there. We don't reach the place, but we want the blessings, but we don't reach the place. But that's not my point. My point is, why did Abraham told the two guys to remain and the donkey there? There must be a reason. You know the problem we have, and the Christian and the people, we are carrying things that we are not supposed to go with them in the sacrifice. You know how donkey behaves? Every one of us, we know how donkey behaves. Even we know the behavior of the donkeys. These two guys were men, they are young men. They could have behaved otherwise. Actually, maybe by that time Abraham was lifting the knife, if those two guys were there, he could have already cut the son, because they are quicker. They are young people. They can do it quickly. We want to go do it. Those were so many reasons why Abraham left the ass there and the two guys. Now, my point is, why do we keep on all what we are doing in our daily life is carrying what we are not supposed to carry when we are going to the altar? We want to give the sacrifice, but we are carrying things that we are not supposed to carry. Why are we carrying the donkey? Where are you going with the donkey? And that sacrifice will not be done when the donkeys are there. That is the challenge we have. We are carrying the donkeys. We are carrying the cart, because the donkey can even pull the cart, and you carry all of them. You are carrying people. You are doing things that aren't supposed to be there, and you want God to bless you. You want to go to the mountain, but still on you still have the train here that are not supposed to go. That's why Abraham told, stay here. I'm coming when I'm done. That's what you're supposed to do today. Tell friends that are not variable in your life, stay here. Let me go. I want to do the sacrifice. Don't carry the donkeys. Donkeys are those kind of things you are carrying. Your character, your behavior, whatever you are carrying, it's not supposed to be mixed by somebody who is going to the mountain. That's why Abraham could not be able. That sacrifice could not be done when those things were there. That's why they were left there. So in our life, what is that you are carrying that is not supposed to be there? What is that you are carrying that you are not supposed to carry? You're supposed to be, it's supposed to be left somewhere, but you are still carrying it and you are going to the mountain. You cannot. That's why we pray, we do so many things, we ask God, we cry, we fast, we do everything we can, but still, as long as we have the donkey in us, as long as we are carrying the donkey and we want to do the sacrifice, it will not happen. That sacrifice will not happen. Not unless at the moment we are going to discover that we are supposed to leave the donkey there so that we go without the donkeys, then the sacrifice will be done. I don't know whether you have ever seen a crusade, or maybe even in your church back in Uganda, maybe my church, people have needs or issues. And when the pastor says, everybody who has issues to come here in front, and people are being prayed, some get healed, some goes back the way they are. The way they came, they go back the same. Why? People are still carrying donkeys. You are carrying even the donkeys to church. And you want to give the sacrifice. It can't happen. It can't happen. You are going to try. I'm going to try. But it will not give the result. Why? Because there is something I have. I could have left it somewhere so that I go to the mountain alone. And when he went without those things, you remember very well the story. When he went to the mountain without those two, those whatever, those servant and the donkey, he did what he did. And everything was okay. And after that, he came back and they went. Now the big question was, why was that reason why Abraham left them there? Was it a stumbling block? I don't know. You have to ask yourself, why are we carrying them? And we are not supposed to carry them. We are carrying things, the behavior you are carrying, and you want to give the sacrifice. Even the friends that you have, not variable even to the sacrifice. The sacrifice cannot even be burnt when they are there, when they are watching. They're not variable. And we are still carrying them. He's my friend. He's I don't know who. I don't know who. I keep on, keep on, keep on. If you want God to walk with you, Mount Moriah, and you want God to provide, because he's going to provide, and he's going to provide if at all, you are going to lead the donkey. But when you carry the donkey and the servant, I don't think God will provide. I don't think God will provide. God will not do that. You have to lead yourself. You have to lead the donkey and move on to the mountain, because God is there waiting for you and he is going to provide. That's why I say, don't complain. The reason why we complain is because we still have the donkey and we are going to continue complaining. If at all we are going to continue carrying the donkey, we will continue complaining. But if at all we are going to leave it, then things will be okay, very smooth. And we are going to receive what we are looking for. So guys, today, let's not carry the donkeys to the mountain. Let's not carry those things that are not supposed to be carried in the mountain. May it be friends, may it be characters, may it be whatever you are doing. May it be this, you know, many things we are doing in life that are not, you know, they are not supposed to be carried in the mountain or in the altar. They are not supposed to be there, but we are still carrying them, and we expect God to do it. I don't know. Let me go back somehow. These two guys, Cain and Abel. You remember when they were giving also the sacrifice to God? Do you think the sacrifice of Abel was God accepted the sacrifice of Abel because he gave the goat or something? No, it's not because he gave the goat. It is because of preparation they did, both of them. The preparation, the process, the way they embraced what God said, that makes different. In fact, maybe this guy could have done the correct process, preparation, this came. The sacrifice could be accepted. But now God looked the way they behaved, the way they did, the behavior, the process, the preparation, the way you embrace, the way they did. And then he said, I don't accept this. And I accepted this one. He rejected Cain's sacrifice and accepted Abel. Why? Was it because he slaughtered a goat? No, it's not because it was a goat. It is because of the preparation he did, what he did. He selected the best. But this guy said, just like that, I'll just do whatever, you know. And there was no preparation, even the heart, the process and whatever, what he did, and God could not allow that. So even us, if we want to give, the sacrifice to God in the mountain, we have to prepare. We have to know, who are we supposed to go with? Who is this person that I'm supposed to allow in my sacrifice? What am I supposed to carry? What are the process? What preparation am I supposed to do so that I set off to the mountain so that God can hear, or maybe God can see what I'm doing, and finally I can receive what I want? That was my message today. Why are we still carrying the donkey to the mountain or to the altar? And you know the behavior of the donkey actually. It can even give the, you know how it barks, whatever, all that sound he makes. He can even could have made it there in the mountain. Maybe things could be things could be different. That's why it was left there. So many things, so many reasons why Abraham left all those things there and went alone with the sacrifice. And when they were there, God provided everything. Why? Because they went the way they are supposed to be. So even us, if you want God to provide, if you want God to do, God to intervene in our sacrifice or whatever, the altar, whatever you are doing, please let us leave those things that are supposed to be there. And you know very well, you are the same person, you know what you're supposed to be having and what you are not supposed to be having. So you know what is needed and what is not needed. You know that. So it's not a matter of, I'll go and read or whatever. No, I know God. This is what I'm supposed to be. And this is the person I'm supposed to have. If you don't have the person, go alone. Because Abraham, he went. Remember, he left the wife. And the wife should be the person who was closer. But she was not worthy to the sacrifice, the wife. Even as me, I'm married, and I can tell you, my wife is the closest person to me in this life. That's the truth of the matter. Even those who are married here, that wife you have is the closest person that you have. But remember, Abraham had that wife, but he never disclosed that thing. Why? Because there was a reason why he never told her. She never carried her. She was supposed to go alone. It was God's process. It was God's process. And God will allow you to go with the people that are supposed to be there. So guys, let's not carry donkeys in the process. Let's not carry donkeys in the altar, in the mountain. Leave them there. Go with your altar, the Isaac. Carry Isaac alone. Go there. Give the sacrifice. God will provide. Whatever you want, God will do it. For that few words, or maybe many, I don't know. God bless you guys, and I love you so, so much. Thank you, guys.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Brother Solomon, for that powerful message.